Hello everyone, myself Sneha Shah from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology from the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. Today I am going to explain you the topic rank correlation coefficient from the unit of basic statistics from the subject of probability and statistics. So if we want to define the rank correlation coefficient, so for that we will use this pairwise rank correlation coefficient. So if we are defining its coefficient, then it will be representing in the form of R. Now what is the value of R? R equals to 1 minus 6 summation d square divided by n into n square minus 1. Now what is the value of d? D means it will consider as degree. It means it will be the difference of relation of x and y. Means d equals to rx minus ry. And the value of n will be representing as number of samples. This particular thing will be used in the concept where suppose if I am taking two judges which will judge some event, the judgment for these two judges will be different, right? So if we are seeing that the first judge will giving some ring, the second judge will giving some another ring. So we will finding that which one is more consistent. So it will be defined by using this rank correlation coefficient. So to understand this, we are solving some example. The first example is two participants in a contest are ranked by two judges as follows. Calculate the rank correlation coefficient. So for that, two judges are given to you in the form of x and y. The different values are given to you as 1, 3, 7, 5, 4, 6, 2, 10, 9 and 8. It means judge x will define the rank as 1, 2, 3 up to 10. And the same thing will be done by the second judge which will be considered as 1. It means suppose if we consider that judge x will giving the rank 1, it will be third rank given by the judge 1. Likewise, there will be difference between judge x and y's rank, right? So if you want to correlate between these two rank, then it will be defined by rank correlation coefficient. So if you want to solve this example, starting with the equation of r equals to 1 minus 6 sigma d square divided by n into n square minus 1. So first of all, we have to find out the value of d and n. Now what is the value of n? We have given the rank 1 to 10, right? So 10 number of terms will be there. So n equals to 10. Now we have to find out the value of d. So what is the value of d? D equals to x minus 1. Or rx minus ry. Now what is rx and what is ry? Rank given by x and rank given by y. Right. So if we writing that rank given by the fourth judge is considered as x, so we writing the value of x. Then we will writing the rank given by the second judge as the value of y. Now if I am taking difference of x and y, it will be considered as 1 minus 3 means minus 2, 3 minus 1 means 2, 7 minus 4 means 3, 5 minus 5 0, 4 minus 6 means minus 2, 6 minus 9 means minus 3, 2 minus 7 means minus 5. Likewise, we are finding for all the other terms. Now, if I am finding the value of d square means square of this value. So, minus 2 square means 4, 4, 9, 0. Likewise, we are finding for all the other terms. Now, if I am adding all these values, so it will give you the answer of summation d square and answer of it equals to 96. Now we are putting this value over here. So 6 into 96 divided by 10 into 10 square minus 1 means 100 minus 1 means 99 into 10, 990. And 6 into 96 divided by 990 and 1 minus this value. So after simplification of this, the answer of it equals to r equals to 0.428. So this way we can solve the example for rank correlation coefficient. Now the next example is 10 competitors in a musical taste were ranked by the three judges A, B and C in the following order. Rank by A equals to 165 up to 8. It means rank given by the judge A will be in this form, rank given by judge B will be in this form, rank given by C will be in this form. So for this you have to find out rank correlation coefficient. So using rank correlation method, find which pair of judges has the nearest approach to common linking in music. It means, first of all, we have to find out rank between A and B, rank between B and C, and rank between A and C. and from that we have to find out which one is more consistent. It means which one is more near to each other. Okay. So for that, first of all, we will write in that if we are taking the difference between A and B, it will representing as B1. Between B and C, then it will representing as B2, and between A and C, it will representing as B. So if we finding R1 means rank 1, so it will be between A and B. Okay, so if we finding that, then 1 minus 6 sigma D1 square divided by n into n square minus 1. Now as you know that the value of n equals to 10, because 10 ranks are given to you, right? Now we have to find out value of D1. Now what will be the value of D1? Difference of 1 and 2 means difference of rank by A and rank by B. It means 1 minus 3 means minus 2, 6 minus 5 means 1. Likewise, we will find it for all the other terms. And then we have to take square of that value, and then we are taking summation of all these terms. So it will give you the answer as summation D1 square. If we are putting that value over here, so we can find out the rank 1 means R1 equals to minus 0.21. Similarly, we will find in for the rank in between D and C. So for that, we will consider that D2. So we are taking the difference between rank given by D and rank given by C. So from that, we will find the value of summation D2 square. And we will find the rank correlation coefficient R2. So for that, the equation will be R2 equals to 1 minus 6 sigma D2 square divided by n into n square minus 1. Here also the value of n equals to 10, because 10 numbers are given to you, right? And the value of summation D2 square equals 214. So from that, the value of R2 equals to minus 0.296. Now the next, we have to find out rank between A and C. So for that, we will take in third term as D3. So the equation will be R3 equals to 1 minus 6 sigma D3 square divided by n into n square minus 1. Here also the value of n equals to 10. Now D3 means it will be considered as difference between A and C. So from this, if we are finding D3 square summation, so its value will be 60. And after putting this value in this equation, after solving this, the answer of it equals to 0.64. Now from this, you can compare the value of R1, R2 and R3. So if I am comparing the value of R1, R2 and R3, so from this you can say that the value of R1 and R2 are near by each other, right? So from this we can say that the value of R3 is maximum. It means the A and C's approach will be nearest to each other. So from this we can say that the nearest approach to the common linking in music is done by the judge A and judge C. Now the next example is obtain the rank correlation coefficient from the following data. So for that, the data is given to you in this format: x equals to 10, 12, 18, 18, 15, 14, y equals to 12, 18, 25, 25, 50, and 25. Now if you want to derive the rank correlation coefficient, so for that, first of all, we are writing x, y. So for this, first of all, we are writing the value of x and y. Now we are deriving the value of rank x and rank y. Then we are taking the difference of rank x and rank y as d. And from that, we are deriving the value of d square, right? So for this, first of all, we are giving the rank of x and y. So for that, first of all, we are taking the value of x. X equals to 10, 12, 18, 18, 15, 14. So suppose if I am arranging it in the ascending order, so the term will be 10, 12, 15, 18, 18, 14, right? So 10 will be considered as first rank, 12 will be considered as second rank, 15 will be considered as third rank, 18, 18 will be seen, so it will be given as fourth and fifth rank, right? So because of that, we are taking average of 18 equals to 4 plus 5 divided by 2 means 4.5 rank to both of these terms. Then the last term is 6th rank. Similarly, if I am finding the value of rank y, so what will be the value? Rank y will be defining by arranging the values of y in the ascending order, so as 12, 18, 25, 25, 25, 50. So for that, we will taking 12 as a first rank, 18 as a second rank, and 25, 25, 25 means 3rd, 4th and 5th. So if I am taking average of this, then 3, 4 and 5, so answer of it equals to 4. So in this 3 term, we are taking 4, and the last one is 6, means for 50 we are taking fixed at the rank. Now we are taking B as the difference of rank X and rank Y. So 1 minus 1 means 0, 2 minus 2 means 0, 4.5 minus 4 means 0.5. Likewise, we are finding for all the other terms. Now if I am taking B square means 0 square means 0, 0 square 0, 0.5 square means 0.25. So answer of it equals to this. Now if I am adding this value, so its answer will be summation B square and answer of it equals to 13.5. Now we are putting this value in the equation of R. So what is the equation of R? R equals to 1 minus 6 sigma B square plus 1 by 12 M1 cube minus M1 plus 1 by 12 M2 cube minus M2 divided by N into N square minus 1. Here in X, 2 repeated terms 18, 18, right? So we are taking M1 as 2. In Y, there will be 3 repeated terms 25, 25, 25. So we are taking M2 equals to 3. And n means number of terms. So number of terms are 6. So if I am taking this value and putting it in this equation, after solving that, the answer of R equals to 0.5429. So this way we can find out the rank of correlation coefficient between any two different terms like X and Y or AB. So we can define the rank correlation coefficient between the different variables. Thank you so much.